The Netherlands have done very well in flood control with a whole series of measures, technological landscape measures to control flooding in the past, but I wanted to show you these images just to make that a little more relative, to show you that the Dutch really do not have everything completely under control yet. There was very heavy rain and flooding through the rivers in 1993 and 1995. These are images of both. So I just want you to realize that this is something that the Netherlands are still working on in a very proactive fashion. How can we redesign our cities and our landscape to make them more flexible, more resilient, so that when flooding does happen, either we can prevent the flooding, or when it does happen, we don't suffer so much and suffer so much damage? This is an urgent question for the Netherlands because, as you can see by these two maps, at least a third of the country is flood-prone if the Dutch didn't have this extensive system of dikes. And keeping the water out is of essential importance for a country where 60 to 70% of the gross national product is earned below sea level, where over half the nation's population live in this western area along the coast, with the four major cities of including Amsterdam and Rotterdam. So if without this tremendously sophisticated and long-developed system, the Netherlands would not be habitable. So perhaps it's no surprise that the Netherlands are now also more forward-thinking than many countries in the world, including my own native country of America, about how to deal with these challenges and find a new path. Just a couple images to show you how important water is for the Netherlands, how much it shapes the landscape, and how intimate the relationship between the Dutch and water is. Some of these landscapes are extremely beautiful. I'll show you another river landscape in a moment. Softly. Yes. And this is a typical Dutch landscape in the west of the country, near the coast, where in the Middle Ages, the inhabitants of this very soggy delta started digging out peat as fuel and would lay the peat along the narrow strips of land left here, lay the peat out to dry, and then come back and pick it up later with boats. And this, we all know now how much energy landscapes influence the way our countries and our surroundings look. And this, I think, is a beautiful example of how the Netherlands and its economy have been shaped by that relationship to energy and to water. One of the ways in which the Dutch have been dealing with water right from the start has been by building dikes. Those were traditionally the ways we did it. We built the dikes to keep the water out. We built the dikes to reclaim land and then pumped to get the water out. And I think this is one of the interesting correlations between the Netherlands and Singapore is that there is a tradition of reclaiming land and using it to expand the country and expand the economy, and also in Singapore for expanding water catchment area now.